Welcome to CT Expert Insights. When your business needs people it can trust, you can count on us. We dedicate ourselves to getting to know your needs and finding solutions to meet them. You'll have a team of experts backing you up.
Hi, I'm Greg Corumbus. Our guest this week on Expert Insights is Deke Copenhaver. He's the former mayor of Augusta, Georgia, who ran at a time that leadership was badly needed in a deeply divided city. He's now a principal at Copenhaver Consulting and a leading speaker and writer on the issue of leadership. His new book is The Changemaker, The Art of Building Better Leaders. And that's what we'll be talking about here for the next several minutes. Deke, thank you very much for your time today.
Greg, thank you so much for having me on.
Well, let's define it first. How do you define a changemaker? We'll dig into several of the characteristics outlined in your book about what that looks like. But to begin, what's the difference between a typical leader and a changemaker?
I think a changemaker is really willing to take a leap of faith and go against the status quo. And just for example, here in Augusta, when I first said I was going to run for mayor, I was 37 years old. Prevailing wisdom, I was told, said I wouldn't get 6% of the vote. But it worked out. And I knew that the people were ready for really ethical leadership. So you've got to be willing to go against the grain and the status quo to really make a difference and be a change maker.
Deke, in your book, you say that true leadership, and I'm quoting now, is not about power and control. Leadership is about making people feel safe, included, heard, respected, and protected. I can easily imagine someone reading that and saying, sure, I want to lead a company where everyone feels valued and respected and feels motivated to put in their best work. But unless you make money, there's no place for them to feel valued. So what do you tell them?
Yeah, well, I'll tell you, Greg, a great example of a company that I just really love and respect is Chick-fil-A. And what Truett Cathy was able to do with that company, you know, it's firm foundations. He treats his employees, he treated until he passed his employees with dignity and respect, but they're still doing that. And he offers upward mobility. I mean, you have so many people that started on the desk that are now franchise owners. So I do think that there are businesses out there and business owners who have established that culture where people are actually excited to go to work because they know that their service is valued.
So let's talk about some of the attributes of a changemaker that you outline in your book. First up is creativity, which means thinking outside of the box, exploring conventional Yes. and unconventional options and so forth. The next attribute, unsurprisingly, is courage, because you'll need plenty of that to stay the course when most people aren't doing what you're doing. So what are the keys to determining which new ideas are good or bad before pursuing them if you're pretty much the only one looking at them?
Well, to me, you know, a big idea without a business plan is a pipe dream. So you need to look at the big ideas, but you need to know, particularly in business, if you're introducing a new big idea, it has to have an underlying foundation of good business principles to go forward. So I see a lot of people that have great ideas, but they have no, you know, business model to go with it. So those just usually fail. Courage, that's here again, it goes against going against the status quo. You're going to have a lot of people tell you that you can't do these things, that you can't, you know, bring forward a big idea that's something different, but you just have to have the courage to plow through that.
Your metaphor for courage is to weather the storm, and you share some very intense personal hardships in your life in this chapter. So whether it's challenges within the business or your own life that can impact your leadership of your business, what kind of leadership does a business owner need to demonstrate when things aren't going as they hope?
Well, and going back with the courage thing, so my father flew B-17 bombers in World War II, and I'm proud to have been raised by a member of the greatest generation. But in any leadership positions, you're going to weather storms. I mean, if you're a business owner, there's going to come a time when you have to lay people off. That's never a fun thing. We had to do that when I was mayor of the city. But really, in that situation, I would try to find everybody jobs. So I went through some very difficult situations in my life. I lost my first wife to suicide before I was 30, and my mother a week after my 25th birthday. So I was a widower and had lost, you know, the strongest woman in my life by the time I was 30. But in overcoming those situations and weathering the storm, I've gone on to have success in, you know, the rest of my life. So Every leader is going to face adversity, but you just have to be willing to keep your head down and maintain your composure and go through it.
The next three traits in your book, Deke, are connecting, listening, and transparency. And these are three areas that have changed drastically in the past generation when it comes to importance for business leaders to pay attention to.
Yeah.
It was very common to see years ago, and in some places not that long ago, a top-down model with employees functioning essentially on a need-to-know basis. So that's changed a lot. But the question that always comes to mind when I see the focus on these areas is encouraging people to be part of it while also keeping the characteristics and the strengths that you have that put you in a position to be a leader. Yeah. In other words, if you have good instincts, you might have people around you that have ideas, they're heartfelt ideas, they're passionate ideas, but they're not really where you want to go. So how do you continue to make people feel valued even if you keep telling them no?
That is a great question, Greg. And really that you are correct. I mean, the world has changed with the millennial generation and trying to be a leader in this situation and be transparent and connecting with everybody. But I'll give you, I go back to my dad. After he passed, I had so many people. He was a very ethical CEO. After he passed, his rank and file employees all would come up to me and tell me that he would walk the floor and talk to them. And I think so that model of connecting with the people you serve from the bottom up is a good one. And it's a tried and true business principle. Transparency, yes, you need to be transparent, but you also need to keep confidences and be aware of that. So it's not just a need-to-know basis, but there are certain things where the people you're leading in a corporate environment, they can't know everything. And that's, once again, you're the leader. Sometimes the buck stops here. But I do think collaborating and, once again, listening, you know, just not discounting a good idea by an employee, just say, that's crazy, we're never going to do that. Listen to them, hear them out, and then, you know, explain to them why. Here again, if it doesn't have the underlying business principles to be successful, I think to listen and then explain maybe is a teaching moment for your employees.
Are these three characteristics that we're talking about here, the listening, the connecting, the transparency, is that now pretty common in most workplaces, or is it still largely a work in progress in a lot of places?
I think it's a work in progress in a lot of places. But I do, here again, I tell people that change in the labor force and communities is constant, and you have to be willing to pivot and to adjust. So it's a work in progress, and, you know, it'll change with future generations. We may go back to a different business model, but for now, it just seems to me, particularly younger people coming into the labor force more and more, which that's the reality of the situation. You know, the millennials are going to be the majority. They're already getting to be the majority over the baby boomers. So you have to listen to them and make adjustments to work in that environment.
We're talking with Deke Copenhaver, and the book is The Changemaker, The Art of Building Better Leaders, here on Expert Insights. And Deke, the final two attributes that you mentioned in the book are character and composure. And these are obviously critical because you want everyone around you to know you're the same person with the same integrity, no matter what the situation is, good, bad, or somewhere in between. What's an example you have of being able to weather a storm or forge ahead, not because everyone was necessarily confident in what was happening at the moment, but because they trusted you or that you trusted somebody else because of established character and composure?
I will give you a great example, Greg, the financial meltdown. You know, I had to be mayor of the city of Augusta, the second largest city in Georgia, during the worst recession in my lifetime. But what I realized was I needed to maintain my composure, because if I was losing my cool and saying, you know, the local economy is going to go to hell in a handbasket, that could start a panic. So I maintained my composure. I addressed it in a very businesslike manner. We were fortunate to come through that situation better than most cities. But the final one that you mentioned is character. And that, to me, I have always been focused on, you know, really looking towards leaders who have good character. I think that that's important. And really, I think the trust factor comes out of that. If you have leaders with good character, you know you can trust them, and that's important. That makes people want to follow a leader.
Deke, earlier on in the book, and this is, I think, a pretty good spot to close on, there's a chapter, or at least a portion of the book early on, where you help people gauge what kind of leader they are. Well, what are the best ways for folks to determine where they are right now and where they want to be? Because folks might be looking at this thinking, oh, yeah, this looks great, but might not be sure whether they actually are where they would want to be in these areas.
You know, I'd say it's funny you should ask that, Greg, and I'm not a big shameless self-promoter, but on my website, deke-copenhaver.com, there's a leadership assessment there that people can take that can kind of gauge where you are in the process. So I would just encourage people to check that out. And I think I would say that we are all leaders in some capacity, whether you're a parent, you know, whether you're a teacher, whether you're a soldier, everybody, if anybody's looking to you for, you know, for you to help manage any situation in their life, you're a leader. And I think we all need to remember that. And we can all be better leaders. I'm still working on it myself. I'm a work in progress. And I tell people it's not a self-help book. It is a work in progress, but it's just sharing life lessons I've learned through being in leadership positions.
And finally, sir, I'd be derelict for not asking this when I'm talking to the former mayor of Augusta, Georgia. How are the Azaleas, and how's Augusta National getting ready for the tournament next month?
And, I actually live on Burtman Road, right? We're a half mile from the back entrance of the National. Things, it's been warm winter. Things have bloomed too early outside of the gates. But generally, somehow, they always make sure that those azaleas look beautiful that the first full week of April, and I know they will again this year.
Can't wait. Can't wait. One of the favorite events every year. Deke, thanks very much for your time today. We greatly appreciate it.
Greg, thank you for having me. It's been a pleasure chatting with you.
Thank you, sir. Deke Copenhaver is the former mayor of Augusta, Georgia. He's a principal at Copenhaver Consulting and is a leading speaker and writer on leadership. His new book is The Changemaker, The Art of Building Better Leaders. I'm Greg Corumbus. For more information on this topic, please call CT at 844-787-7782.
With 125 years of experience, CT is here to help you at every stage of the business life cycle.